Welcome to my YouTube channel. So today we are going to make pretty interesting copper complex, that is copper 2 citrate. So from this copper citrate we can make pyroboric copper. That means pyroboric copper means they are very fine particles of copper metal. So to start with the reaction we need two chemicals. You can see here, this is our chemicals, copper 2 chloride and sodium citrate. So I have taken about 30 grams of each chemicals, 30 grams of sodium citrate and 30 grams of copper 2 chloride. If you don't have copper 2 chloride, you can also use copper sulfate. It is okay, and you have to calculate the stoichiometry and get the amount what you need for the reaction. And this is important, you can get the correct stoichiometric amounts of both chemicals. Here I am using little extra amount of copper 2+. Here the sodium citrate is limiting reagent, so I have extra amount of copper chloride. From that I can make sure all the citrate is precipitated out as copper 2 citrate. Because if we use extra amount of citrate, that will dissolve our final product copper citrate as a complex. So here I am using little extra copper chloride, and our limiting reagent is sodium citrate. To dissolve both of these compounds in minimum amount of water, and we need to heat both solution until that temperature reach about 90 or 95 degrees, close enough to boiling. Okay, so now I'm going to dissolve it in distilled water. Okay, now the copper 2 chloride solution is close enough to boil, and I heated the sodium citrate solution. Now I am going to mix these solutions together and keep heating and mixing until we see a precipitate. And now you can see, clearly see the precipitate of copper 2 citrate, and this is more green in color than you see in the video. Now I am going to stop heating and let the solution cool down to room temperature. Now the temperature of the solution is reached to room temperature, and now you can clearly see the copper citrate green color precipitate and unreacted copper chloride. And now we need to filter this mixture and dry the copper 2 citrate. After drying the product, this is how our final product copper 2 citrate looks like. Now to get pyroboric copper, we need to decompose this copper 2 citrate, and let's go for that reaction. This test tube, I have taken about few grams of copper 2 citrate. Now we need to heat this copper 2 citrate and decompose the product. Now you can see here, when I heat the test tube, the green color turns to blue color. That is because the green form is hydrated form of copper 2 citrate, and this blue form is anhydrous form. So when I continue to heat, this copper 2 citrate is decomposing and it gives very fine particles of copper. Normally, copper metal is not react with oxygen in the air, but these fine particles can react with oxygen in the air and burn. Now let's see how it reacts with oxygen in the air.